Use Oracle Spend Classification to analyze your spend data, classify transactions into spend categories, and refine the accuracy of the categorization. In this video, you'll learn how to classify a data set. To start, from Procurement, go to the Spend Classification work area. We'll start with uploading a taxonomy. A taxonomy is a method for categorizing and classifying a set of data. You can upload new categories or update existing ones. Download the categories to make updates to the existing ones, or delete the categories if needed. The taxonomy file has a taxonomy identifier, a unique ID for each category, name, and description. We're using a simple structure with one level, but you can have up to 9 levels for the taxonomy that you can define using the Edit Categories menu option. Now, we'll prepare a training set. A training set uses a set of examples for the engine to understand how to classify the data. It contains representative example of your data. For example, if there's an invoice that contains purchase of the laptop, the training set shows that spend should be classified under hardware. You can use the available datasets like expenses and payable invoices and create a sample training set. Download the expenses dataset, then manually enter the categories for the transactions and upload it. Make sure to remove the header row and change the name of the dataset in column B before you upload the file. If you choose to include the date, use the year/month/day/day format. Or you can use an already prepared training set and upload it. Choose the scheduled process and the import processes and upload the prepared training set. Remember that the file you're uploading shouldn't contain any headers. It should only contain data with the categories populated. Submit the scheduled process. Go to the Spend Classification work area. In the Datasets tab, you'll find the training set that you uploaded. Next, we'll create a knowledge base. A knowledge base is also called a model in data mining terminology. It's a representation of the patterns present in a dataset. Give the knowledge base a name. Select the training set you just uploaded and set the taxonomy to create the training set. Refresh the page and check the status to see if the knowledge base creation is completed. Let's go to the final step of classifying our dataset. Classify one of the predefined datasets, such as payable invoices or classify Q1 invoices, the dataset you've uploaded. Click Classify. Select the knowledge base you created. Give a name for the classification batch and select a business unit. You might also want a count of the number of transactions you're about to classify. After the classification is complete, you'll find the newly created batch in the Batches tab. Open the batch to review the assigned categories. You can make any corrections needed for a more accurate classification by manually assigning categories. Find more information on individual transactions by clicking on the transaction. You can compare the categorization of transactions before and after the classification process and review major deviations that may require intervention. Positive and negative influencers give you an indication of the impact of certain words in the training data on classification or category prediction. Now you can complete the improvements to the category classifications and approve a batch and view various visualizations by spend categories on the performance page. After the data is approved, the spend classification results are available for reports and analysis in the Oracle Transactional Business Intelligence application. Thank you for watching.